Hi, I'm Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com. In this video, you will learn how to create an easy PowerPoint animation effect that has been requested by a lot of our subscribers. It's festive season again, and people want to send e-greetings to each other, and one of the simplest tools you can use to create your e-greetings is PowerPoint. In this video, I'll show you how to create your e-greetings using this flashing serial light animation. Once you know how to create this basic animation, I'll show you how to come up with your own variations like this one, which has a lag built into it. And if you want it more colorful, you can use this option here. And if you want to add some more bling to make your greetings even more festive, you can use this option here. Can you see we have lights blinking all over the place? And the best part about this is you can come up with your own variations. For example, if you want to wish someone on their birthday, you can use the same effect with this variation. And if you want to use this effect in a business setting, you can come up with this variation. You can announce a winner here, or you can write your favorite quote here. There are n number of ways in which you can use this beautiful effect. So let us learn how to create this surprisingly simple yet highly versatile effect from scratch. Here I am on a new slide and I've used a simple blank layout. The first thing I'm going to do is to change the background to a dark color so that we can have our light showing beautifully. So let me right click, go to Format Background option, go to Fill, use Solid Fill, go to Color and use a dark color like so. The next step is to draw the wire around which the bulbs are placed. So let us go to Auto Shapes Gallery. From Lines, let us click on this option called Curve. Then click outside the slide area. The reason is I don't want the beginning of the wire shown in the slide, so I want to click outside. Then let me click down, and as I move my cursor here, you can see a nice curve getting formed. I click again, and then click again down here, click again. Don't try too hard to make your wave look uniform. We are going with the natural flow here, so keep drawing the wave the way you want, and then double click outside to complete creating this wave form. Then let me go to Shape Outline and give this white outline so the wire is clearly shown. The next step is to draw our bulbs and the glow around them. So go to Auto Shapes Gallery. From Basic Shapes, pick up this oval tool, hold the Shift button down as you draw a small circle like so, and then go to Shape Fill and fill it with white color. Go to Shape Outline and say No Outline. Now we have the bulb ready. Next, we are going to create a duplicate of this by pressing Ctrl D, and then we are going to add some glow around it. To distinguish this glow from the bulb, I'm going to give this a different fill color. So let me go to Shape Fill and fill this with the yellow color here. And then let me go to Shape Effects, go to Glow. You can either use one of the presets that you see here, or you can create your own glow. So let me go to Color and choose the color of the glow to my liking. I want it to be this bright yellow. And I can increase the size of the glow by clicking on the option here. You can see I can keep increasing the size to my liking. I'm going to keep it really bright here, 18 points. And then I'm going to adjust the transparency. Now this is zero transparency. I want it a little more transparent so that it looks like glow. Now we have got everything in place. We have our bulb and the glow. Now we want to arrange this glow behind the bulb. So I'm going to right click on this and say send to back. And let us keep this bulb right on top of the previous one. And then we have our bulb and glow combination ready. If you want, you can arrange everything by going to Arrange, Align, and then say Align Center, Arrange, Align, and say Align Middle, just for good order's sake, and press Ctrl G to group it. The next step is to arrange these bulb and glow combination around the wire. So let me move this to the place here. And then hold the Ctrl button as I click and move this to its new location. Then hold the Ctrl button again and then place it in a different location. So I'm just going to arrange the bulb and the glow around the wire so that I can complete this entire design. So there you go, I completed creating the bulbs around the wire. And as you can see, I've not really tried to keep equal distance between the bulbs because we want to go for that natural look. And now I'm going to select all of this and ungroup the bulb and the glow. So let me right click and then say group, ungroup. Now we have separated the bulbs from the glow. The reason is we want to create two groups now. The first group has just the bulbs and the second group has the glows. To do that, I'm going to hold the control button down and click on the circle that I see here. As I click on the white circle, you can see that the top layer is selected. We are not selecting the glow, and that is something that you need to keep in mind. And as you can notice, sometimes it can get hard to select the specific shape that you want. So you can hold the control button again and click on the object that you selected now so you can deselect it and then change the order of selection. Since we are anyway going to create a group of all these objects, the order of selection doesn't really matter. So let us carefully select all these white bulbs and make them into a group. And there you go, we have selected all the bulbs. Now let us press Ctrl G to group them. How do we know that we have selected just the bulbs and not the glow behind them? It's very simple. You use your arrow key to move them out of their original place. And now you can see that we have selected just the bulbs. Let me press Ctrl Z to put them back into place. Then let us give this group a name called Bulbs. For that, let me go to Home, go to Select in the Editing group, go to Selection Pane, and here we have the group and the individual bulbs here. Let us change the name of the group to Bulbs. So let us go here and say Bulbs and hit Enter. Now we have renamed the first group. Now I'm going to click on the eye icon so that I can make that invisible. Now we only have the glows. Let me select all the glows with my cursor. Press Ctrl G to group them. Now we have a group of glows. So let me collapse this and then call this group Glow. So let me rename it as Glow and hit Enter. Now we have two groups, one of bulbs and the other of glow. To this glow, we need to add custom animation. Let me go to Animations. Go to Animation Pane so you can clearly see what I'm going to do. The animation I'm going to apply here is emphasis animation. The specific animation we want is not available here. So we are going to use more emphasis effects. Under exciting, you can see blink option. That is the animation we are going for. Let me say okay. And we are going to make some change here. Let us go to the animation event, click on the drop-down menu, go to effect options. We are going to have this repeat until end of slide. So let us say repeat and say until end of slide. And we need to have this happen with previous. So there is no need for anyone to keep clicking this and then say okay. Now we want the bulb also to show. So let us go to the selection pane once again and let us uncheck this one that we selected earlier. As I click on this eye icon again, you can see everything is visible. Now when I go to slideshow, you can see the animation in action. The glow is switching on and off or blinking, and you can see that the bulb is present there all the time, giving this a nice serial light animation effect. Now to complete the e-greetings, I'm going to select everything and move it slightly up so we are able to create our top border. Let me press Ctrl D to create a duplicate and then move it down so we are able to create our bottom border. Then we need to use our text box to write our text here. So let us go to Home, go to Auto Shapes Gallery. From Basic Shapes, I'm going to pick up this text box tool and let me write Season's Greetings. Let me change the font color to something brighter, like say white color. And let me really increase the font size like so. Now that looks really nice. If you want that additional effect, you can always use a handwritten font. The one that I really like is something called Brillotus, and it is available in B. Let us go here. This is a special font that I downloaded, and you can see that the effect is really stunning. Now, when I go to slideshow, you can see the complete effect. This is a nice looking e-greeting, isn't it? Now, let me show you some variations of this beautiful effect. Let me go to animations and go to animation pane again, or you can select the animation pane from here as well. You can see we have two animations. One is for this top line. Another one is for the bottom line. Now I'm going to select the second line and I'm going to add a bit of delay. We know that the duration is 1 second for the animation. So I'm going to add a delay of 0.5 seconds. Now observe what happens. You can see that we have the blinking happening of the first and the second in a rhythmic fashion. So this is a nice variation. Now, if you want to keep this more colorful, you can change the glow colors. For that, let me once again go to the selection pane by clicking on the option here. And then when I collapse this, I can go to glow. You can see we have a whole bunch of glow effects shown. Each one represents a certain glow in a group. When I select this, you can see the specific bulb that represents that glow. So let me hold the control button as I want to select multiple glows here. and let me select the various glows at random. You can see we have selected different glows here. Then I can always change the glow color. Once again, let me go to effect options, and then the glow color that I want to use is a different color, maybe this bright red color. Then let me choose some more glows and change their color. Once again, let me go to the selection pane. Let me hold the control button and select some other glows. Let me select this, and that represents this glow. Let me select something else and select something else. Now, when I click again, you can see that sometimes some of the bulbs that I'd already changed the color would appear. You can always click on the same shape and deselect it. And that is a very important thing. Now we are going to select this. You can see that we have red color here. We want to change that. So we are going to click again on the same one. And then let us choose another bulb. Now we have selected different bulbs, and let us give this a different glow. So once again, go back to the effect options. And this time I'm going to use this bright blue color. Now you can see when I go to slideshow, the way the effect looks is like this. You can see that there is a lot more festive feeling here because we've used different colored bulbs. Now, what if you want to have the animation in such a way that these set of bulbs animate first, and then this one, and then this one, and then this one? It's very simple. First, let us select everything and then ungroup them. So I'm going to right click and say group, ungroup. Then I'm going to make four groups. Let me select the first group by holding my mouse cursor and then selecting the first set of bulbs and glows and press Ctrl G. Now this is our first group. And then select the next set of bulbs. This is our next group. And then select the next set of bulbs. This is our next group. And then select the remaining, and we have our next group. We have four groups now. Now we are going to apply the same blink animation to each of the four groups. So let me select the first group. Hold the shift button down, select the second group, third group, and the fourth group. Then let us go to the animation pane once again, and we are going to apply blink animation. So let us go to the animation options, go to more emphasis effects, and then under exciting, let us select blink and say okay. Now we have these animations shown. We don't really want to have this animation happening, so I'm going to select this and delete it. Now we have these four animation events. Let me hold the shift button down as I select all four animation events, go to effect options, and then say timing, and say repeat until end of slide. And we want all of them to start with previous. And let us say okay. Now we have all four animations happening with previous. Now to have this one animate first and then this, we are going to introduce a bit of delay. So let me select the second group and then add a bit of delay, say 0.25 seconds. And then the next one and add a delay of 0.5 seconds. And then the last one and add a delay of 0.75 seconds. Now when I go to slideshow, you can see the animation happening. It's a nice little effect, and this is the way in which you can see the bulbs glowing during some festive seasons. Now instead of drawing a curve and placing your bulbs around it, if you draw a circle and place your bulbs around it and apply the animation effect that I just showed you, this is the result. To create this variation, you first draw a rounded rectangle and then you place your bulbs around it. I created a group of the ones in the outer rim and a separate group for the ones in the inner rim and have them blink alternatively to create this beautiful effect. Now, as you can see, what I showed you is just a simple idea. It is up to you to fan this park into a big blaze by applying your own creativity. You can create multiple templates with your own creative variations and have a stack of them available to wish your friends and families on different occasions. After all, PowerPoint animation is powerful when you add a generous dose of creativity to it. Now, I want to show you some creative example templates taken from our comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle version 2.0 that show you the true power of purposeful custom animation. Here, we show four steps with custom animation. On a click, we show the first step with a hand coming and drawing the first step. Then on a click, you show the second step. Once you finish explaining, you go to the third step and then the fourth step, like so. Can you see the difference in impact this slide can create compared to the traditional bullet points? Let us go to the next example. Here we show going up the hierarchy. On a click, we show the entry stage, which is stage one. Then on a click, we show the next stage where only a few members go through. Then on a click, we show stage 3, where even fewer go through, and then we show the final stage like this. Compare this to the static pyramid diagram that you normally use to show going up the hierarchy. Let me show you another example. Here we show one cause, one effect with pictures. It's a very simple and commonly used idea. On a click, we have details of cause with the picture. Then on a click, we show details of effect with the picture. Let me show you another example. Here we show the basic idea of 1 leads to 3 with pictures. This is the first one, which is the source. And then on a click, we show the result like this. Can you see here? It's a very interesting way to show one cause, multiple effects. If you want to create a variation of this and add a bit of graphic to tell your story, you can have this variation. Here we show how 3 ideas originate from one core idea. On a click, we show the first idea that got inspired from the core idea. And then we show the second idea that is inspired, and then the final idea that is inspired. If you see, it was the same basic idea, but given a creative twist. Let me show you another example. Here we show 1 multiplies to 3. We show the 1 like this, which is the original entity. And then on a click, we show how 3 other entities come from the original entity. If you want to show another concept, like say 1 input divided into 4, you can show this. Here we have a large funnel which receives the input like so, and then we have the outputs into 4 different databases. If you want to show another variation, we have 5 ideas from thinking process. We show the thinking like this, and then we show the 5 ideas like this, and then we draw the attention of the audience to every individual idea like this with the bulb glowing. These are all some creative ways you can use your custom animation. If you want to tell a complete story with your custom animation, you can do so if you apply creativity. Here we want to show the basic idea of 3 elements combining to give 1 result. Here we have used a popular metaphor of blender to combine the various ideas. On a click, we show the first ingredient, the second ingredient, and the third ingredient. And then we have all 3 ingredients go into this blender. Then it is blended. And then on a click, we move the content onto this tank, which shows the combined result. There are so many ways you can use this animated metaphor in your business presentation. All these templates and more are available in our comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle version 2.0. This bundle is a collection of more than 4,200 professionally animated PowerPoint templates to make your presentations beautiful and engaging. I will leave a link to this useful product in the description box below the video. You can click on the link, come check out more details about the product. Watch this video, read various testimonials, see how the various animations look, and if you think that this is the right product for you, then you can make a one-time purchase and use these templates for a lifetime. Once you start creating your PowerPoint presentations with templates from comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle, you would never want to go back to your old ways of creating your presentation. If you are a professional who needs to create presentations as part of your profession, then this is a worthy investment. So go ahead, click on the link in the description box below the video and check out more details about this useful product. Finally, as always, if you want to sign up for our 25 Creative Ideas free PowerPoint mini training, you can click on the link here. If you like this video, please give this video a like, share it with your friends, and hit the subscribe button to join our 200,000 other subscribers who are taking their PowerPoint skills to the next level by watching our YouTube videos. To watch our latest YouTube video on PowerPoint, you can click on the link here. Go ahead, click on the link in the description box below the video, check out our comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle, and I will see you inside.